Hi, Glenn Zottola here. My approach to playing jazz by ear, part one. When I was a kid, I had something called perfect pitch. I didn't learn it. It was a gift, I guess. And you don't have to have that to play jazz. A lot of great jazz players don't have perfect pitch. But basically, when I heard a note, I could identify what it was. C, D, E, F, G, etc. I could even tell you what the note was of a car door slamming. It was an advantage for me being a total ear player. Duke Ellington said the first thing he looks for in a musician is, does he know how to listen? And I think the key word there is how. For me, my key approach to jazz was one word I would call emulation, not copy. I never transcribed any solos using my own notes, but emulation, and I guess you could use another word, which would be empathy. In other words, feeling what the other person is feeling. Like if you had a conversation with someone, they're going through a good experience, a joyful one, or even a bad experience, could you be them? Could you feel what they're feeling? So when I'm listening to any great artist, Louis Armstrong, Charlie Parker, Miles Davis, Stan Getz, Clifford Brown, I'm able to feel what they're feeling when they're playing. And it's such a key point to be able to do. For example, you could transcribe and learn all the notes of someone's solo, and then you play it and you sound nothing like them. Why? Because you're not feeling what they're feeling. So that has been my secret to when I listen to music. I'm listening a very specific way. I'm listening for things like, what are they feeling? What's the emotion? Technically speaking, where are they putting the time? When I say time, for example, Louis Armstrong's time was so unique and new when he came on the scene. He laid way behind the time, and an interesting story, because I worked with Bud Freeman, a very famous saxophone player from the 20s, and he said when Louis Armstrong first came to Chicago, Chicago was a big jazz town, he said, me and Bix Beiderbecke, now Bix Beiderbecke was a very famous cornet player from the day, went down to hear this new guy in town, and at first we could not understand what he was doing. We never heard anyone lay back the time like that. And we came back several times and we began to love it. But it was so unusual where Louis was putting the time. That is one of the things that I absorbed when I was a kid, because Louis Armstrong was my first mentor. My dad was friends with him. And I really absorbed by listening and by observation where he was putting the time. And also what he was feeling. Now, another thing I'm listening for, how does the guy come in and out of phrases? He's embellishing. How does he slide into a phrase? How does he get out of a phrase? The embellishments, so to speak. Now, Louis Armstrong's embellishments were completely different than Charlie Parker. When I asked my dad how to play jazz, he said, just embellished a melody like Louis, and I did that, and I totally got it. But then when I moved forward to Charlie Parker, it was completely different, but it was the same concept, embellishing the melody. So when I was on the road for a year with the Broadway show Chicago, after each show, I would sit down and listen to Charlie Parker, and I would get how he's coming in and out of phrases, how he's approaching that. That's another way of how I would be listening to the music. Another thing would be mood. What kind of mood is the guy creating? Is he creating beauty? Is he creating excitement? You know, like Louis Armstrong, he had a certain punch to his sound that was different, let's say, than Miles Davis. And Stan Getz, tremendous amount of beauty, Miles too. So I'm listening to all these different moods that the guy is creating. And we're not even talking about notes here, you see, because I'm using my own notes, but if I get all those characteristics, oddly enough, I can play, and it says, oh my God, he's got the nuance. He sounds like Clifford Brown. He sounds like Charlie Parker, but I'm not playing their notes particularly, okay? I got reviews that talk about that all the time. In fact, when I sent the Just Friends track, which is a very famous track of Charlie Parker, to a very knowledgeable musician friend of mine, he says, "Oh my God, when I heard that, I thought it was Charlie Parker." And that was out without Charlie Parker licks and notes, okay? So this is learning how to listen, which has been my successful action and a key point to learning to play jazz, especially by ear. So I'm going to include two little excerpts that'll give you an idea of what I'm talking about, emulation or empathy. The first thing would be the introduction by Charlie Parker to Just Friends. I'll play his introduction, and then I will play my introduction with my own notes that my friend thought it was Charlie Parker. And then the other thing would be, I was thinking of doing a project that was similar to the very famous album Stan Getz did, Focus. So I thought I'd overdub with Stan Getz to try to get into his head. And I have a term for this from the old TV show Star Trek, where Spock did this thing called the Vulcan mind meld. Well, I do that musically. I get into the person's head, and I'm able to get all these emotions, all these feelings, how they're approaching the music, all the things I'm talking about. And you can learn very, very fast with this kind of approach, and then using your ears, which the ears are so, so powerful. Even if you know all the theory in the world, okay, and you're totally knowledgeable, you've gone to college, without the ears, you're not going to make it. You have to have both. And if I was going to choose between one or the other, I would choose the ears, because I don't have the other. And one more thing I want to say about all this and my approach. I'm really not an innovator, but I feel that doing what I'm talking about and emulating and absorbing where these greats are is the only route that will lead you to your own individual personality. And I have never been accused of copying. In fact, all my reviews and all the people I've played with say that I have my own thing, my own sound, because I've melded together all these influences using this system, and it's become my own. Okay, so here we go. This is Charlie Parker's famous intro to Just Friends. And then right after that, my intro using my own notes to Just Friends. Stan Getz from his famous album Focus. This tune is called A Summer Afternoon. I'm overdubbing, playing with Stan to get into his head, the Vulcan mind meld. Stan plays first, and then I play second, and then we trade back and forth. Thank you. And now one more on trumpet I'll add, which is from my Clifford Brown with Strings tribute. First we have Clifford doing Yesterdays, and then my version of Yesterdays.